Canoosplex all night long.
And one of the worst homes that we've seen hit here in the metro is out in Elkhorn. KETV News Watch 7's David Earle begins our storm team live coverage. Good morning, David.
Dark neighborhood, or what would be a completely dark neighborhood if not for the lights that we have brought here with us this morning to Elkhorn in the metro. We're near 204th and West Maple. The road we're on here this morning is Camden Drive. It was the site of massive damage yesterday, and I want to step out of the way and show you just exactly what we're seeing here at this home here on Camden Drive, where the roof completely ripped off yesterday. But the storms that came through this neighborhood didn't stop dozens of neighbors from rushing in to help these homeowners here. You can see right here from video from last night, all of the neighbors rushing in and out of the house trying to save what they could for the family here. About 20 or 30 of those neighbors, in fact, they were out taking mementos. They were getting the valuables out of the home, the china and the silver. And because as soon as the roof came off here, everything was open to the elements. While the home is still standing, all of the water damage from losing the roof will surely make this a costly repair. The homeowner even telling us he thinks it may in fact be a total loss. Now, Cliff Carthauser says he knew it was going to be bad when he heard the sound of a freight train.
We were underneath the front step in kind of a little bomb shelter area, and just incredible noise, and I thought it was our deck furniture and our gas grill being blown off the deck, and so it was, you know, 80, 90 mile an hour winds probably.
In fact, the wind so bad yesterday, it comes straight from the roof, came straight from the house right across Camden Drive into this fence right here. It is a steel fence, and the damage from that roof has just blown this fence over and damaged it here. Some of the debris even traveling further to a nearby home. That person now has a skylight in his bathroom where he surely did not want one. We're live in Elkhorn this morning. David Earle, KETV News Watch 7. John and Alex, back to you.
All right, David, thank you. And more damage in Omaha. A tree causes trouble near 36 in Sheffield. Strong straight-line winds caused the damage at this woman's home. Inside, you can see where part of that branch punched through the ceiling. Corey Reeves says that they were watching the storm coverage when they realized it was right on top of them.
Just a loud bang. We thought it was the thunder. And we didn't think anything of it. And then I walk in the room, and there's drywall all over the floor. And then I see basically a branch, like a huge branch, and it's running down the wall. And there's water everywhere, and it's pretty bad.
Now Corey and his grandmother are okay. He says there's not much he can do about the branch until it's safe to go on the roof. And this morning you may find some challenges as you head out the door.
Yeah, we have crews throughout the metro to make sure you know what to expect on your commute to school or work. Our team coverage continues with KETV's Watch 7's Chin Doan live in Millard. Good morning, Chin.
And good morning. Here's one problem for some people as they leave their home for the day. Trees and other debris blocking their doors. Now we're in the neighborhood of Stony Brook, just down the street from Millard South High School. Now the residents here, take a look at what these folks are dealing with. Their 40-year-old tree split in half thanks to strong winds, and now their means of transportation, well, they can't get to them.
In there somewhere is our sedan, our Elantra sedan. And you can see the pickup truck is mostly covered, but not totally.
So Todd Hall and his family thought their vehicles were stolen when they came home around 9 o'clock last night. Their neighbors say they didn't hear anything like a lightning strike or the tree falling, but the debris blocked their garage and nearly all their doors, so they couldn't even get inside their home. But they finally got in through the back door, and luckily they saw very little damage inside. Now that's what it may look like in your neighborhood west of the metro. Let's take a look at what it looks like closer to Midtown and the downtown areas. The storm caused less damage there, but you may be dealing with problem areas like this one here near Fontenelle and Fowler. Now those tree branches and debris in the streets, a hazard for some residents. Now trees like these falling on power lines, well, it's left a lot of people without power and electricity for the past 12 hours. More than 20,000 residents in the Omaha and Council Bluffs metro were without power, and some still right now. So you may want to check on your alarm clocks and other electrical things this morning before you head out the door also. We're live near 149th Street and 149th Avenue. Chin Doan, KETV News Watch 7.
All right, Chin, thanks very much. Our team coverage continues in Beaver Crossing. Here's KETV News Watch 7's Dave Roberts.
Tornadoes left the town of Beaver Crossing in shreds. Most of the population here has been evacuated to Utica, where they're staying the night inside of a school. Meanwhile, business owners here in the downtown area are doing what they can to board up and try to keep people out of what's left of their businesses.
Yeah, the roof is back over there behind that other building.
Around town, trees have been shredded by the high winds. Some people saying as much as 3 tornadoes came here through town, like fingers of God ripping trees apart and laying them on top of houses.
Yeah, I don't know really what's... I know this building's a loss because the bricks are all loose and from when the roof got ripped up.
It's been a very difficult day here in this whole area. Even in the town of Friend, there's been damage as well. Some of the tornadoes also in this area caused multiple power outages. Even in places like this, they're having a difficult time trying to clean and board up overnight because there's not a lot of light, because there still is no power. Of course, we'll stay in touch with people here in Beaver Crossing and bring you the latest on the cleanup and recovery efforts. In Beaver Crossing, Dave Roberts, KETV, Newswatch 7.
Well, a downed tree takes out a gas line in Elkhorn as MUD crews are called there to respond. It happened as the initial storm moved through just before 7:30. People nearby say they heard a loud boom, but it wasn't until they went outside and saw the tree that they smelled gas.
MUD, they couldn't get to the main source, but I think they just found it and was able to get it capped. So they got the gas turned off to our house, so we were able to stay in our house tonight.
Patrick Hastings says he is thankful that tree didn't hit any houses. MUD crews contained the leak shortly after arriving on scene.
An Elkhorn business extends its hours to help people affected by the storm. Home Depot's hours usually keep the store open until 8. Well, Sunday night, it left its doors unlocked to supply those in need.
Seeing all the damage that the community endured over the past night, we decided to stay open, and we'll stay open as long as the customers need us to stay open.
Now, plenty of people took advantage of the store's extended hours. We saw customers as the rain continued to calm down. Well, the storm kept moving through the metro area and east into Iowa, where the damage continued. The storm struck the town of Panora in Guthrie County, Iowa, after 10 o'clock last night. Our sister station in Des Moines tells us there is serious damage along nearby Lake Panorama. Lakefront condos and outbuildings all struck up by that storm. There are no reports of any injuries. 509, still a little active this morning. Obviously not as bad as it was last night, but still seeing some rain.
Correct. No watches, no severe thunderstorm warnings in effect. There are flood warnings around the area.